Hello everyone, this is Tholin with another Retroid Pocket 2 video. This time we are going to focus on the PSP emulation that we can have on this device. Now PSP or PlayStation Portable is a very successful portable console made by Sony with a huge library of games. For this emulation we are going to use PPSSPP, a very common and successful emulation for the PSP. We will start with some system settings that we need to change in order to have a better performance. But before we go there, let me fix the focus of the camera in order for you to have a better look on the settings. You don't have to take any notes. I will also have all these settings in the description of the video. So let's begin. First of all, we have to have fast memory and stable checked and IO on thread also checked. Then we should go and change the CPU clock. You can set that either to 111 for less demanding game or above 200 to 225 for more demanding ones. Now we should go back to some graphics settings and see what we can do there. This is the most important part of the customization of PPSSPP in order to improve performance. When you go to graphics, you will see that the backend is locked to OpenGL. There are no other options, but you should change mode to buffered rendering. The next part has to do with frameskipping. You can change frameskipping to 1 to 5 and also have auto frameskip checked. Post-processing should be off, and then we can go to performance. Here you select rendering resolution to auto, display resolution you select native, it will restart, and then you select the following: hardware transform, software skinning, vertex cache, the lazy, and then you disable slower effects. Finally, you should go to texture, have upscale level to off, and then deposterize uncheck, and also anisotropic filtering uncheck. The last step is to go to hack settings and set the lower resolution to safe. It is good to note here that these are the general settings that you need to apply in order to improve overall performance. You may need to micromanage some settings depending on the game you want to play and how demanding it is. We can now check 5 games to see how they perform, and we will start with God of War, which is quite demanding. The case of God of War is special, as you need to set the clock to 111 in order for it to run properly. And even so, you will see a lot of flickering on the screen and a bit of delays during gameplay. Actually, God of War is not the most playable game that you can try with PPSSPP, but we are trying to run it to see how it performs both on the cinematics and also on the actual gameplay. So this is the main options for the game. Not much that you can do here, but we can go to new game, select our difficulty, and begin with the cinematic. As you can see, there's a lot of flickering in the cinematics. The frames per second during the cinematics are above 60, but still the flickering is annoying, so you may have to revisit some settings, play with them in order to find the ideal combination. As you can see, during actual gameplay the flickering becomes worse, the game is uncontrollable even with the clock set to 111, so I don't believe that this is a game that can be played on the Retroid Pocket 2. Moving on, we are going to try Castlevania Dracula X. This is again a demanding game, but you will see that the performance is much better compared especially to God of War. As you can see, the frames per second are more or less 30, but they will remain so throughout the game and the cinematics. So if we move forward and skip the introduction, I will go directly to the options to start a new game, and we can see how it performs. During the cinematic introduction of the game, the frames per second will move from 15 to 30, but still it's not that bad. You can easily follow the story and what is happening on the screen. And when it turns back to your controls, there is no input lag and you can play it normally, as you will see right now. As you can see from the response time of the pressed buttons that I'm using, there is no input lag. You can enjoy this game to its fullest. There will not be any major frame drops during gameplay. So, in general, we can say that Castlevania Dracula X is one of the playable games using PPSSPP on the Retroid Pocket 2. I am going to show you some extra gameplay to see how well the game performs, not just with regards to animations, but also the special effects are nice. So, as already mentioned, you can enjoy the game to its fullest. This is one of the special moves that you can use with no frame skipping or frame drops. The third game we are going to try is Call of Duty. This is another demanding game. It's based on a 3D engine that I do not believe can be supported by the Retroid Pocket 2 hardware. But still, we can have a look at how it performs. In the beginning, you will see some nice frames per second. But when the actual game starts, you will see that the frames are around 5 to 7, and even when you try to move around and use your character, even fire, you will see a lot of input lag and a lot of delays. In general, I would also categorize Call of Duty Road to Victory as an unplayable game on the Retroid Pocket 2 using PPSSPP. Moving on, we are going to play Ultimate Ghosts and Goblins, a remake of the classic by Capcom. This is a platformer, but the graphics are also demanding. So, what you will mostly notice on this game is an input lag. It has some frame drops and also a bit of delays as you play, but the main issue is that you will have a lot of input lag, as you can see here in the actual gameplay. I will also try to play a little bit with the actual settings to see if we can improve that and have a follow-up, because so far it seems that the Retroid Pocket 2 can support the game, but there are a lot of issues that may have to do with a bit of optimization on the settings for this particular one. The fifth and final game of this video is another platformer called Prinny Can I Really Be the Hero? This is a very well-made game with very nice graphics. The backgrounds are 3D, but the characters and monsters are 2D. The sprites usually are 2D. And it runs with absolutely no problem on the PPSSPP emulator on the Retroid Pocket 2. As you can see during gameplay, the animations are smooth, the frames per second are more or less locked, and it performs really well. I strongly suggest this game as it is one of the best platformers for the PSP and it runs excellently. Everyone, thank you all for watching. Be sure to thumb up if you like the video and follow the channel for more updates.